Hormone deprivation therapy, meaning the lowering of serum testosterone, has many known side effects, and a lot of men are afraid of those. Let's talk about how to best manage those. The main side effects observed with hormone deprivation therapy are directly linked to lowering the serum testosterone and its effects. Obviously, sexual dysfunction, loss of libido, and erectile dysfunction are associated and most concerning for a majority of men treated with this modality. Bone health is another issue. If untreated, long-term hormone deprivation will lead to osteoporosis and bone loss. Hot flashes are not very dangerous, but affect the quality of life of the patients. There is generalized fatigue. There is loss of muscle. And maybe clinically more important, we have seen that hormone deprivation long-term is associated with dysregulation of cholesterol, of increase in blood sugars, and there has been some suggestion that cardiovascular risk might also be increased. So when we're talking about managing the side effects, we have to distinguish between those that affect the patient's quality of life but are not life-threatening, and those that are potentially affecting the patient's health and survival. For sexual dysfunction, what we do recommend is, prior to initiation of therapy, counseling with a sexual counselor to prepare the patient and his spouse, if indicated, for the side effects that will be encountered. This has been shown to help with coping of the patients. In terms of bone loss, we do recommend dietary calcium and vitamin D intake daily, regular exercise, and specific bone-targeted agents that are approved for this indication, such as denosumab. Generalized fatigue is difficult to treat with medication, but we do recommend regular exercise 4 to 5 times a week for about 45 minutes, which has been shown to help in that regard. In terms of more serious side effects, such as metabolic syndrome, hyperlipidemia, glucose intolerance, these are factors that should be known and actively managed by your treating physician, meaning regular blood tests and initiation of appropriate medication if, for example, your cholesterol levels are going up. If you look at the actual risk for cardiovascular disease and death, the link is less strong than some people might think. In the largest trials, if you combine them and look, there were actually not more cardiovascular death observed compared to controls. So while it is important to control the blood sugar and cholesterol, it is important for patients to know and put into perspective the right risk-benefit of treatment of their prostate cancer with hormone deprivation.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed, but right now a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment, or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor, and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.